guys, welcome to Alistair Aquatics. I hope you're doing well. In today's video, we're gonna take a look at my planted betta and cherry shrimp tank. Okay, so this is a nano tank. It's on my desk at the moment in my bedroom, and it's been set up now for around a month, and this is just gonna be a quick update to see how it's got on, maybe what's gone well, and what issues I've encountered along the way. Okay, so I hope you enjoy this video. Let's see how we get on. Okay, so here's my planted betta and cherry shrimp tank. And as you can see, I think it's doing absolutely great. I don't know if the camera is catching that purling. I think it is. The plants are purling. The Monte Carlo is growing in like mad along the bottom here. We're starting to get quite a thick, nice carpet. I'm gonna just leave it, not trim it, see how it gets on. The betta fish alpha, he's still doing well. Let's see if we come to the top. He's still doing great. One thing I have noticed is he's ripped his fin at the back. I think he swam behind the plants and swam behind this rock, and I think he slightly tore his fin. Okay, so there's one little tear in his fin. But other than that, he's really healthy, doing great. And if you look closely, I'll bring the camera closer later on in the video, but the population of shrimp in this tank has exploded. I've got a lot of baby shrimp, multiple generations. Some of the baby shrimp have now grown into adults. You know, this tank is doing absolutely fantastic. I've got a few bits of frog bit at the top of the tank that are floating plants, and those floating plants, the frog bit, had grown like crazy. I had to pull a few ginormous bits out. They'd sent huge roots down all the way to the bottom of the soil. And I mean, it looked fantastic, but it was starting to shade out the rest of the aquascape. So I needed to remove those. But the plants are just looking absolutely incredible. I mean, the purling in this tank is brilliant. The bait is happy, the shrimp are happy. And this is an absolutely beautiful thing for me to have on my desk. And it's definitely a big distraction. Some of my friends who are into fish keeping have come around, had a look at this tank. And this is definitely their favorite. Okay, so for your planted tank, I think this is looking pretty good to me. I mean, I don't see any huge algae problems. It's doing great. So just to remind you, this is just a nano tank. It's a very small tank. I've got red cherry shrimp in here. I think I started with about 13 and I've probably got around 40 now. There's a really strong colony going at the moment. And I've got 3 Amano shrimp in here. So it's looking pretty good, definitely. What I'll do now is I'll take you in for some closer shots. Let's see how we do. Okay, so let's zoom in now, see if we can get a better look, see if we can spot any of those cherry shrimp we were talking about. Oh, there's one just here, resting on this piece of dragonstone. And Alpha's come to say hello. I still find it amazing. I'm very happy that he completely leaves the shrimp alone. He does not mind. I think the real key to it is finding a fish with the right personality. I mean, when I bought him, he was in the tank with a load of other fish, and he just gets on absolutely really well with all the other shrimp in this tank. Annoyingly, I have just fed the cherry shrimp in this tank. I threw in their food just behind this large piece of dragonstone in amongst the moss. I'm sure they're having a right old party in there, but sadly they're not out the front to say hi. We have got an Amano shrimp. Okay, quite a big Amano shrimp just chilling here. Let's see if we can spot any more cherry shrimp. Oh, here's one. Oh, and I don't know if we can see, but just there, perched on that bit of Java fern, is a baby shrimp just chilling out. Okay, so this tank's doing really well, an incredible amount of purling. I did just do a water change, so I'm really liking how it looks. This sort of side view is really great, you can see all the way along the tank. It is quite a densely planted tank, but I think for what I've got in it, one betta and some cherry shrimp, I think it looks great, and I'm really enjoying how it looks. Okay guys, sadly that time has come. We've reached the end of the video. This is only a quick video, but I really do hope you've enjoyed it and maybe learned something, taken something away from this video. I'll be sure to keep you updated with this tank in the future. And this is bye for now. Okay, so until the next video guys, leave a comment down below, let me know what you think about my planted betta and cherry shrimp tank. And leave a like if you've enjoyed this video. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Bye for now, guys.